Institute of Archaeological and Monumental Heritage of National Research Council. We talk about another remote sensing technology, that is LiDAR, which represented a revolution indeed for archaeological prospection. And I will present some results from a study related to abandoned medieval village in Basilicata. Well, just to start, I want just to put in evidence that it is important to know the object of to be investigated if we want to use in effective way remote sensing technologies. And in this case, it is important to know how is the process of the formation and alteration of soil and subsoil if we want to identify from above feature traces of archaeological interest. This is the well the process of the degradation of building architectural elements which become remains, and after the it starts a sort of physical interaction between these remains and surrounding soil, causing a change in moisture content, vegetation growth, which could be visible from above. And these marks, the most common are the crop marks, are useful to identify and to discover important archaeological sites. It was the proxy indicator used by archaeologists for all the century, the past century, but could be used also using multispectral imagery. And so we can also today identify a sort of spectral signature of crop marks, which help us to identify area of possible archaeological interest. But the optical data exhibit some limits in the case of vegetation, of course, because cover potential archaeological remains, but also in presence also for bare soil, in the case of, for example, micro topography, which are another important proxy indicator. And in for this situation, LiDAR it is a very effective technology, thanks to its ability to obtain accurate digital models, which allow us to identify and characterize microtopography of archaeological interest, and thanks to the ability to penetrate, to filter the vegetation, which represent a really a great big step forward for archaeological prospection. The typical workflow data process includes the proper preprocessing, the processing, I mean the classification of points clouds, and finally the digital terrain model, which could be done considering that the object of our investigation is not, for example, the topography or urban planning, but is the archaeological prospection. So in some cases, for example, low points are not information to remove, but could be useful to identify, for example, grot caves on hypogeas. But there is another step, important step, that is the post-processing, which enhance, which facilitates the interpretation. This is this is the convexity map, the slow map, very simple, and other more complex way to post-process based on methods of diffuse illumination of digital models, which allow us to identify, to extract feature archaeological interest, and to facilitate the archaeological interpretation. One application regards the study of some medieval villages in Basilicata. Here you can see the number of villages abandoned between 13th and 14th century. This event was something global event due to the Black Death, climate change, and a number of other reasons, among which the change of the land use. It was a big crisis, a sort of a big European crisis, which involved a number of regions, for example Sardinia, for example Basilicata, which where there was a reduction of the number of villages of the 30%. So we are studying, investigating some sites. One of these is Torre Cisterna, dated around well, the beginning of the Norman Age, abandoned between the 13th and 14th century. I pass to the results obtained by using LiDAR. You can see after the filtration of the vegetation, you can see this hilly plateau, which exhibit, and it is more easy to detect and to see by using these visualization techniques like scale factor. You can see, for example, the castle, the tower, some roads, a number of micro relief related to possible, probably, probable buildings. This is another results of this approach. You can see the micro relief related to the castle, which is dated. It is known by historical sources, but any news were known about the characteristics of this of this archaeological site. Here we developed a method of extraction of a feature. So starting from the digital model, now we can extract in automatic way most of the archaeological feature which have been interpreted with a visual inspection. So you can see all the city walls, part of the castle, another part of a sort of a extra mural, I don't know in English, extramania walls. And this is the all the entire methodological workflow, well, including also the study of historical maps, historical cartography, and with this hypothesis of interpretation of these early settlements. Cisterna, the story Cisterna is strictly linked to the history of Amalfi, and now we they are celebrating the 1000 of the foundation of Amalfi. This is another medieval settlement, Irsum, abandoned in 13th century, founded in 11th century. Here you can see the added value of these technologies. This is an orthophoto. This is the LiDAR, LiDAR the dam derived from a LiDAR survey. These are the enhancement by using a local relief model, which for sake of brevity I can describe. This is the sky view factor, and you can see now the shape of these buildings. You can see also this ditch which separate the castle. This is a typical, well, a typology named Motte and Bailey, a sort of a courtyard. You can see another phase of expansion. You can see also the traces of a landslide, which could be probably was one of the causes of the abandonment of this site. You can see the you can compare the orthophoto, the DTM derived from LiDAR, and the derived model by using these post-processing methods. This is a hypothesis based on the some archaeological records, and based also on the morphological analysis of these settlements. You can see the first nucleus based on the Motte and Bailey, including the castle, a second phase of expansion, a third phase of expansion, and the landslide. So in this slide you can see also the entire history of these settlements from foundation to abandon, including the landslide. And this was the base for the beautiful reconstruction of a part of these large settlements. It was also the base for a divertissement, because we did also a sort of a serious game related to the reconstruction of these medieval villages. Thank you very much.
Masini, some comment? No, oh, comment, please.
On the last slide, how did you identify the first, the second, the third phase, not only from the remote sensing, I suppose?
Well, We don't have archaeological record dated to medieval villages, but some other records of other period. In that case, was also only an hypothesis based on the morphological analysis, based on the comparative analysis with other medieval settlements dated to Norman age, dated to the same period, more or less. So we identify, for example, this is a sort of artificial hill named Mott. You can see and this is a clear trace of a ditch which surround this first nucleus. So it's strictly linked to, it is based on comparative analysis with the similar medieval settlements, not only of southern Italy, but also, considering that we have we are in a period, the Norman period, so we can do also some comparative analysis with other medieval settlements all over Europe. This you can see a different shape, morphological characteristics of this second phase, and it seems that could be this other area. It seems like sort of another expansion. Maybe it could be equivalent to this, but it seems that the chronological relative evolution could be the same, the following, first, second, and third. And finally, the landslide interrupted the history of this medieval village.
Sorry, Nicole, I have to reduce the time for the talk and for the question, sorry.